Yo guys, Jonathan here. The 16-inch MacBook Pro is official. There are a ton of really enticing things with this machine that I cannot wait to dive into. But conversely, I also couldn't help but think about the possibility of a 14-inch MacBook Pro. The baseline $1,299 13-inch MacBook Pro that Apple dropped earlier this year was one of their best values in a really long time. And if they took everything that was refined with the 16-inch MacBook Pro, that would be incredible. Imagine a version of those better speakers, that microphone, that slightly thicker design which leads to a bigger battery, better cooling, and more importantly, that bigger display. So with the 16-inch MacBook Pro being official, it kind of gives us an educated guess of what that 14-inch display could look like. The now retired 15-inch MacBook Pro had a resolution of 2880 by 1800, whereas the new 16-inch MacBook Pro jumps up to 3072 by 1920. That's an extra 192 pixels wide and an extra 120 pixels tall. So if we apply that to the current 13-inch MacBook Pro, which has a resolution of 2560 by 1600, that could theoretically lead up to 2752 by 1720. If you missed it, I got a chance to sit down with Mr. Philip Schiller and talk 16-inch MacBook Pro, which was awesome. I will link that down below, but I also couldn't help but ask him, does this 16-inch MacBook Pro mean a 14-inch update is coming?
No, I wouldn't draw any extrapolation from this to anything else. But there certainly had been a narrative over the last few years that Apple didn't care as much about pros, it wasn't working as hard to make products for our pro customers, and that simply wasn't true. But there were things we were doing we needed to bring out to make that real for people. And there was a pace that we needed to feel like we could accelerate, and we have. And there's work we've been doing internally with our pro workflow team that has had a huge benefit in how these products are brought to market and how they're used. So I think there's things we've gotten better at, things we need to accelerate. The caring has always been the same.
Right.
Execution hasn't always been the same.
Right. What would you say was the biggest shift in the execution versus, if the carrying was there, what changed execution-wise?
On the one hand, it worked out with the technologies that we've brought to market over the last year, that we were able to line up a whole bunch of things at the same time over less than a 12-month period, and where that wasn't possible over previous few years for a myriad of reasons I can't get into all the details. But we did have a point in time where we decided, look, we are going to make iMac Pro, and we're going to make a new Mac Pro while we're also making new Pro notebooks. There have been many times throughout history where people have questioned, with the rise of notebooks, which is the vast majority of what our customers buy, is the investment on a new Mac Pro or the idea of an iMac Pro worth it, or should we just put even more work on the notebooks? And those questions always go on at Apple, at other companies. And there was a point where we said, forget it. You know, the feedback from customers has been so strong that they don't think we're putting enough attention on the Pro customer. We're going to do all of that. We're going to create this thing called an iMac Pro, and we're going to do the Mac Pro, and we're going to do even higher end MacBook Pros than we have ever made before. And we were all, a lot of us, really proud that internal decision was made to do all of that. It was always a question of some of that, but the question was made to do all of that. Okay. Even to make a beefier Mac Mini. Like, the team is even happy about that's in the mix of all these things.
So should we potentially expect updates in the near future with the rest of the lineup, or is that?
No predictions, but you know, what's the old Beatles line about the love you get is, you know, equal to the love you give, or I'm gonna muff that line. But all I say is to all customers, especially the pro customers listening, the more you appreciate these products, the more you embrace them, the more you show how they matter, the more that enthuses the team to keep doing more, right? It's a self-perpetual system. The more excitement customers have, the more we want to do. And customers really do have an impact on the choices Apple makes down the road. And sometimes you can't see that, right? People write in emails, they write letters, they do podcasts saying something, and they don't realize that depending on what that thing is, it can be anywhere from 9 months to 5 years later where that impact is felt and it ripples through the system. And so to me, the best input is always positive, supportive, you know, criticism that is constructive, is, you know, we'll take the other stuff too, but it really does motivate people.
So nothing concrete yet, but fingers are crossed. And I appreciate Phil being so down to earth and not dodging questions. And again, if you missed that full video, it's linked up here and down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. This is Jonathan, and I will catch you guys later.